she is. Don't you just hate school reunions?
So, Miss Graham, it's your first time with us, but don't worry, it's just a routine smear. So just relax. You doing anything nice tonight?
Actually, yeah, I'm meeting up with some friends. I haven't seen them since we were at school.
Oh, I love looking up old friends. Hello, who is it?
It's Stephen Dixon.
Well, I know Stephen Hawkins, but he's very articulate and got a very clear voice. How do I know you?
Timmy, we read the news together.
Got time for the sport now, and if you don't want to know the results, just look away now.
Okay then, and now over to the weather with Wincy Willis. Wincy. I went on holiday with my sister and my mother. Way back now, my sister must have been about 18, yeah. And during the flight, the captain came over the tannoy and said, I'm sorry, but you will all have to take, you know, the brace position. We're about to crash. Well, my sister, she went hysterical. She was running up and down that aisle going, oh, I don't want to die a virgin, I don't want to die a virgin. She went up to this fella and went, oh, make me feel like a woman, make me feel like a woman. He took his shirt off and said, here, f***ing iron that. Stephen Dixon, welcome to you on my bed, welcome to you. Well, you're welcome to chew on my bed. That's rude. That's how it works this way, yeah.
It does.
Where did you train?
Well, I did. I trained really at hospital radio in the Lakes.
Oh, okay.
That was the thing when I was sort of 16, got into hospital. It's the way you do it.
I am 16, going on 17.
So then were you talent spotted or head spotted?
No. Sadly not. I worked at Five for about 4 years. I sent a show tape off to Sky to a wonderful woman called Yvonne Ward, who was just like the office manager.
Yeah.
God love her. But she said, oh yes, come in, do some shadow shifts.
That like stalking?
Just stalking. You just go in and stalk a presenter.
And so, you're not doing anything but just following somebody round?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the idea. Only I went in to do this with an old pro called Alan King.
I know his dad.
Yeah.
Wayne.
Yeah.
Right. I said it.
You did.
Should have done.
So he did midnight and the 1 o'clock and the 2 o'clock. And then he said, oh, you do the 3 o'clock.
1, 2, 3 o'clock.
So I just had to get on with it.
But it's a big plod to get from that to then Anchorman of Sky.
Yeah, but there's a lot of, you get a lot of people in the business who push and push and push for big things, and I've never, oh, she's rude. But I've never believed in that. I think you've got to know what you're doing and progress more slowly. So I just literally carried on and just went up incrementally. I did other freelance
work. Lovely word.
Incrementally.
Yeah. Because I used that expression with my husband last night.
I'm not going to ask what you were doing.
I didn't ask him what he was doing, but he was doing it.
Do it incrementally.
Ask the one.
Oh, sounds rude.
Who said it? And so when was the big day?
Big day.
That they said, hello, darling.
Hello, darling.
Do they do that at Sky News?
I believe not, no.
Oh, they should do. It's more friendly.
It would be nicer.
What we want you to do is anchor for us. Drop anchor.
Drop anchor. Well, they didn't. They never did. They never have.
Are you meant to have that job then, or you?
No, I've just
stayed.
One of these days,
you've shadowed yourself and then stayed
they're
over.
They're going to work out. They're going to think, who the hell's that?
You haven't had the pleasure of me yet, have you?
You've got your lovely top job. We did you go out celebrating that day when you got that? Were you like, I've arrived.
My dad. No.
No.
And do you know what? Sky is very good at keeping you
grounded.
Grounded.
And not in the sky.
Not in the
sky. Do you
sky.
See what I did there?
It's clever,
aren't that? I good?
Some jokes are timeless.
She,
You talking about
she,
me?
She,
No.
Oh, your dad.
My dad. He sent
me dad.
He sent me a crate of wine.
Me dad. Me are dad. You from the Caribbean?
No.
Talking about Caribbean music.
You're reading your news.
Yeah.
What are you wearing?
Suit.
But are you wearing it all the way
all
down?
All the way down. We've always had a big news wall, so a big wall of stuff that we can walk up and down, video wall sort of thing. So we do have to get our lallies on display.
I farted your lallies earlier, dear. While you was changing.
You did. Walked in on me, changing.
I didn't mind. Blatant. So you do wear that, so that's blown my theory.
It has blown, yeah, sadly. Sadly.
In fact, you blew my theory, didn't you? Sadly. Earlier.
You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off.
You do the morning slot, don't you?
Mornings now. No, I've done everything. Because you get...
That's what I've heard, girl.
Yeah, it's true.
You said it.
You get...
And where are you happiest?
Mornings.
Okay.
Happiest now. I've never been happier.
M-H-A-P-P-Y.
Oh. I can see.
You can see.
Hello, big boy.
Is there anyone you
I
think,
hate working with.
Yeah, yeah. That you just think, oh, I can't bear that they're on there. And you do the smiles.
There has been in the past people that you dread going in to work with.
I don't like Gillian either.
Gillian Joseph. Gillian is my on-screen wife.
I can see it.
I love her. I love Gillian.
This is going to sound funny, but if you love her, why didn't you marry her? You're diabetic, aren't you?
I am diabetic, but that's not why I don't drink, though. I used to drink.
And why don't you drink now?
Because I think I was getting too fond of it. I think when I was 30, I thought, I'm just getting too fond of it.
No, I've lost you. What do you mean?
I'm a bit drunk now.
What's life like without the drink? Isn't it dull?
It's...
No, I meant to say, aren't you dull?
Aren't I dull?
Sorry.
I don't have time for the dead or the dull.
I do think I'm considered more boring than I was.
Yeah, and I'd have to agree with you on
you
that.
But so, I am dull and boring.
Yes, yeah. I mean, we've done that. I mean, the viewers are going to work that out themselves, girl. Have you ever had to do breaking news?
I did the London bombings. That was when I was on.
And were you on already and that happened while you were on?
Breaking news we're getting from the PA Newswire that there's been reports of an explosion outside Liverpool Street Station.
So what happens in that situation?
Well, it's to be honest, it's the same with any breaking news, is that something will either drop on the wire system, so which is where a lot of international and national news comes through, or we'll get a tip through and my producer will say, we've got this breaking news. And you literally get one line and then they just say, break it. And then when it's big, like that, and you know something is happening, you just literally have to keep it going. So you will just be what we call going open-ended, which means you stop, which means you don't go to any breaks, so you don't do anything, you just keep rolling on it constantly.
I've done that. Yeah.
There you are.
Who hasn't? So, what happens to your adrenaline when that
through
happens?
Through the roof.
Are you a little bit, I don't want to leave it because I'm on a roll?
You can be, but I think with Sky, you know, when it's time to come off air and the next lot of people are standing,
you bring
in the
yourself
wings,
off.
You do bring yourself off.
Right. You know, and I have got a lot of experience of that.
I can imagine you have.
Yeah.
You've got quite hairy arms, actually.
Well, I used to be a man.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
I really could see what actual people used to say.
Lovely telling of the news.
And well, by a really
that,
nice
I mean a
jolly
royal
stuff.
Wedding.
I've done a royal wedding.
Have you?
I've done. I did William and Catherine. Not as it was going on, but I was doing news at 10 that night from the palace.
Oh, okay.
And all that sort of thing.
Oh, so. Just picking up the pieces then. Not as much as you wanted to make out there. You were like, oh, Anne's got drunk and she's fallen over, lost her clutch. Princess Anne, I'm
thought. Oh, look, yeah,
like Princess Anne would have a clutch. She's got over the shoulder, isn't she? She wouldn't have a clutch.
The nice thing is that on that night when I was doing the show, and there was the reception in the palace. And Camilla and Charles left at one point.
Come on, let's get out of here.
And a friend of mine who used to work with them sent me a message saying, oh, Camilla and Charles have been watching you on doing News at 10. Oh, and now they're driving.
And that's why they've left.
And they're about to drive past your live position, so.
Give them away. You know at the end of the news, and they go, ooh, and they do this. What are you talking about?
Well, we don't do that anymore.
Should have done.
But
when you did do it.
When we did do it, and we used to have a wide shot as well at the beginning of the show.
Well, you'd need one with your hips, wouldn't you?
And I'm so glad to see you not only kept your gorgeous figure, but you've added so much to it.
I said it.
But you just used to, you say ridiculous things, actually.
Are you saying rude things?
It was sometimes, you know, certainly in the morning show, Gillian would be saying, one down, three to go, or whatever, in the wide shot.
Or maybe I'm late month.
Or some. No.
And I always say she's a cheap slut.
Look at you all, Liberace. Isn't got any more jewellery?
Do you like
got
it? On. That'd be bling.
She's nice. She's good.
I'm sorry you think more of my soul than you do of my diamonds.
Is that all you do? Home thing? Are you not a social
animal?
I'm
not a social animal. No, I don't really do the whole show busy party stuff and all that. I don't really like it.
Why not?
Because it's really super. What you've got to remember is I'm a northerner from a working class.
Can't forget that,
no,
darling.
But a northerner from a working class background.
It's like literally talking to Elsie Tanner here, girl.
It's all about realism for me, and all the show busy stuff is so fake.
How am I faked?
Are you invited to lots of do's?
Some do, not lots, some. And you know, occasionally you go to an awards ceremony or something if there's a big one, or give out the odd award. Sounds a bit weird.
You're always up for a big one, aren't you?
But I'm not, it's not my it's
Have
not
you
my
given out team. Awards?
I gave out an award a couple of weeks ago, actually.
For what?
It was Man of the Year.
Do you get wined and dined in 69?
I got wined and dined.
Oh, we'll 69 you later, dear. okay. What is the future for Stevie Dicks?
No idea.
So what is...
But that's the exciting thing, isn't it? I've absolutely no idea.
No idea, have you?
I've no...
When I looked at you and I thought, you've got no idea.
What are you talking about?
Well, good luck with all of that. It's been a pleasure having you on my bed.
I wish I could say the same.
Isn't she rude, that one? Got a mouth on her. So I've been told. now what I like to do, I don't know, you're a fan of my show, so you know what I'm going to do
actually,
now.
You're going to do a selfie.
Oh! She said it!
You've got it on video.
So let's have a look.
That says it all.
Should have done. So what we're doing is looking in this hole, found through. You ready? Your right, what I've got here is something different for you, because you're a lovely news reader, I say that loosely. sounds rude. But what I've done here is I've got you a presenter, and this presenter's very close to my heart. I don't know if you've seen it before, but it's her last day.
Right.
And she likes a sherry, so she's celebrating her last day. What you're going to do when this broadcasts, maybe on Sky. You'll be celebrating your last day, won't you? So let me just play her. I think her name's Paula.
Right.
And it's a local radio. And it's her last day. She's just enjoying herself.
Right.
So let's hear it.
Paula White.
Oh, it's Paula White.
Paula White.
time, let's say, you pick the music.
It's always better when you are. And that's all I'm saying on the matter.
Paula, enjoy your day and thanks for being yourself. From Glenn. Paula, we'll miss your wit and sense of humour. Look forward to Saturdays. From Sandra in Stone. Thank you. It's a P-A-R-T-Y because I said so.
Yeah. She's not added
too
many.
This is my last show. I want song suggestions. Look, let's just throw it all out. I don't get told what songs.
No, she does get told.
But I don't get told what songs to play. On the last day of my show. So, if you want a song, Susie's looking. Oh my goodness.
What?
If you want a song, party. Last day with Paula. I don't care.
Obviously.
Whatever you want to hear this afternoon, it's like you can hear it. Rich and Talk says, Paula, you sound drunk. I'm not drunk. I've had a couple of drinks. I'm not drunk.
She's not drunk, is she?
I'm sad. Paula Stoke, we'll miss you, Paula. Shame you're going. Won't be the same in the week. You're listening on the Saturday, says Rog and Bengal. And wishing you all the best for the future, says Rog and Bengal. Oh. Right, songs today. Not just the last song, but songs you want to hear. Carte blanche. That's what they call it when you've got a free range.
She said it.
Like to hear Charlie Rich, Most Beautiful Girl in the World. Tina. She means Ruth.
I got that wrong because
I'm tanked. Going back by Phil. Back where?
What?
And Gazza and Staffer says A-E-I-O-U-U. By Freeze. Oh my gosh. We've got to play that anyway.
She's been drinking for about 24 hours.
I think.
Thank you very much indeed.
I think when she started her job, she started her drinking.
Between now and 4 o'clock, we're having a party.
I think we've got that, Paula. You're having a party, aren't you?
We can.
Because we can.
We absolutely
can. Okay.
It didn't work. So... shall we go for the Beatles?
I don't think Paula's going to work for much longer, is she?
Oh, bless her.
It's my last day and nothing's working. Why is nothing working?
Is she drunk, love?
Because you're tanked, dear.
Let's try this.
And why don't you worry about this?
Perfect day by various artists. Obviously, it's 25 minutes to 2. Good afternoon. Unfortunately, Paul is... not feeling quite well, so it wouldn't be her last afternoon show. So she's gone home, so unfortunately, or fortunately, as the case may be, you've got me till 4 o'clock.
And what about, she's not feeling very well? I shan't feel very well either, and she's gone out. Hang on a minute. Who's gone? Stevie Dicks. I'm going to give him a newsflash he hasn't seen before.
Dixon. Oh, it's the Timmy Toilet Show. I wish we had some breaking news so I could interrupt this transmission, Timmy.
I don't want to tie it down, but it would be so good with you around. Well, I know it sounds funny, but I don't want to be in love, just want a piece of the action.
Oh, Timmy, this is a piece of the action I really didn't want to see.
To get a piece of the action. To get a piece of the action. To get a piece of the action. Piece of the action. Piece of the action.
Oh, Timmy, I've really, really got to go. I've got to get up early in the morning.
You said it.